You're tuned in to Living Black, coming to you from Warman in Western Australia. In just over 3 weeks' time, the cream of Indigenous talent will walk the red carpet at this year's Deadly Awards, being held at the Sydney Opera House. SBS has scored two nominations, Living Black for TV Show of the Year and Aaron Fazzo for the Best Actor Award. The East West 101 star is currently working on a new production in Cairns and took some time out to speak with Living Black. Dan Conifer reports.
Cockroach.
He's the Indigenous action man of Australian police drama East West 101. But for Aaron Fazzo, the rise to stardom hasn't been easy.
To try and crack it as an actor anyway in this industry can be quite hard, let alone trying to be an Indigenous actor, then let alone trying to be a Torres Strait actor. And so you're kind of the minority of the minority.
Aaron is no stranger to adversity. His Tongan father died when he was just six, and Aaron was raised by his Saibai Island mother and grandmother. But he got his first acting break on the SBS series Remote Area Nurse, an appropriate start for the former health worker.
I'm not my father.
There was an audition on Thursday Island, basically threw a sickie the next day and borrowed a dinghy and went across, and the rest is history, so to speak.
A novice back then, but to get through, Aaron drew upon traditions of dance and storytelling from his youth.
We grew up with cultural performance, the language, the traditions, knowing your identity, your clan, your, in terms of your status, where you stand in the family. So that was kind of instilled into us from a very, very young age. And so it was always, performance had always been there.
For his latest series called The Straits, the 35-year-old is both an actor and a producer.
You know, I want to tell more stories from up here, and it's about keeping that cultural authenticity and that cultural control and making sure that our stories are told correctly.
No doubt though, Aaron's fans won't want him spending too much time away from the spotlight.
Well, that's almost all we have time for today from the Kimberleys. Next week on Living Black, nuclear fallout. We investigate how the controversial government proposal to store radioactive waste at Muckaty Station in the Northern Territory has divided a community.
We don't need the money just to sell our country. We need money without selling our country.
That's next week on Living Black. If you'd like to see today's stories again, visit our website at sbs.com.au/livingblack. You can also follow us on Facebook and Twitter. On behalf of all the team here in the Kimberleys, I'm Carla Grant. Thanks for joining us. We leave you with Microwave Jenny, the first act of our new music series showcasing Indigenous talent.